There's got to be something done here. You can't get rid of all cops because then crime's just going to go through the roof. But, like, I don't know. Can you stop these people that are, like, idiots from becoming cops? What about Kim Potter?
Yeah, I was going to see if...
Kim Potter.
You want to play this?
What is it? I don't want to see this again.
Okay.
I don't want to see a guy getting shot again. We're trying to do... Listen, this is a comedy podcast that talks about real shit. I don't want to start doing torture porn. I'm not Lena Waithe.
I think this was about Kim Potter specifically.
Oh, yeah. Well, then let's watch that.
I haven't seen this yet.
26-year veteran of the force is now charged with second-degree manslaughter and has been arrested.
What are you upset about?
It is my belief that the officer had the intention to deploy their taser, but instead shot
Mr. Every cop, look at how close his eyes are.
I know.
Every cop, look, there's a real problem here. You know what it is? It's not a great job. Most people are figuring out ways to not be cops. And I think the people that are becoming cops, it's really not it's not the best and the brightest.
Yeah.
What were you giving a face to earlier on in the video?
It was like an EDM drop for when it's like...
Yes. Yes. Well, you got to keep people into it. You got to keep people into it.
It's insane.
You got to keep people into it no matter what's happening. You need an EDM. The song's kind of dope as fuck. Can you keep playing it?
Yeah.
To right with a single bullet.
The song is dope as fuck.
Left and right!
Oh, and they're sampling.
Left and right!
Yeah, I mean, can someone get this bitch out of here, too? Put her in jail. Kim Potter. Her name, she should be in jail. Kim Potter. Stop hiring these substitute teachers to giving them guns. This woman should have been teaching health. Not even a real thing. You gave her a gun. That's a good idea, huh? Yeah, I look at my Aunt Kathleen. I go, you know what? She needs a weapon. Here's what the calf needs. Here's what a middle-aged menopausal woman needs, a weapon. And it's not all gendered, but there's a lot of women out there that agree with me. That's the reality. There's certain jobs women should not do. Mm-hmm. There's a few jobs women shouldn't do. President, senator, congressman, cop, doctor, lawyer, fire department, banking, financial tech, math, higher education, any education above third grade, a chef, a manager of a hotel, CEO or CFO, COO, CIO of a company, investing, VC, venture capital, driving Ubers, Lyfts, cabs, working at aquariums or zoos or hotels, entertainment, you know? And then there are things that women are perfectly suited to do, like the Dear Abby column. Remember, people would ask her advice, and she'd write. Yeah. She'd be like, Dear Lovelorn in Oklahoma, I understand what you're saying. But in all seriousness, you know, we got to watch them a little. You got to watch them, these ladies. Am I wrong? I'm not trying to sound misogynistic here. He's the gay misogynist. But there's certain Kim Potter didn't know the difference between the gun and the taser. Is that a problem? Is that an issue? I'm asking. How about? If you're going to have cops, you need them to be real lesbos, big bull dykes, because they have a sense of justice that I don't always agree with. But Kim Potter, I believe, can we find out she's a heterosexual before I make this point? But I believe Kim Potter, husband.
Yeah, she's got a husband.
This is a problem. You need a lesbo. As much as it pains me to say it, and as much as they've given me a lot of hell over the last year, you need lesbians. And not those lipstick lesbians in the desert. You need a real hulking, just like if you wanted to interior design a house, you wouldn't bring in me. You bring in a real gay person, like a real gay guy who is like really gay and got it. When you have a woman cop, she needs to be a real lesbian, like a barn-raising, dykes on bikes lesbo. Because that then men will respect her. No one respected this woman. So she had to try to be cool and shoot people. With, you know, she didn't know the difference between her gun and a hot glue gun. She should be teaching a second grade class. This is what Kim Potter should be doing. All the kids, come to the, and remember they would get the parachute and you'd put the balls in the middle of the parachute and you'd go like this and then the balls would go up in the air. That's her job. Not shooting people. And who's her husband? God, he's...
Jeffrey Potter.
Is he a cop too?
Jeff worked as a detective.
I don't know. Maybe one person should not. Maybe like you can't be allowed to have two cops in love. Mm. Cop love. Cops need to go back to when it was New York Undercover. Look up the show New York Undercover because it was a black guy and a Hispanic guy and a tough talking Latina chief. And that worked. Look up New York Undercover. Mm. Lauren Velez. Malik Yoba. Oh, Patty D'Urbanville was the chief. Yeah, get this. Patty D'Urbanville. Okay. Yeah, she was the chief, and she made sure everything was fair. God, is she better rough. She looks good. She was the chief.
Mm-hmm.
And then there was Malik Yoba and Michael DiLorenzo and Lauren Velez. They were all detectives. And then the lieutenant was this woman, Kim Potter, it looks like, actually. But... I don't know what to do anymore with what's going on with the cops. It's very bad. I don't know anymore what to do. I just don't know. I think that you have to stop letting... the psych evaluations for these people have got to be much better. Some of these cops, the psych evaluations, do you even know how bad they are? Some of these cops, the first question on it is, who do you want to shoot the most? That's not good. They go, what race do you want to shoot the most? That's the cop evaluation. Here's another question. They go, if a cop in your vicinity shoots a baby, will you plant a gun on that baby? And a lot of them go, yeah. That's question two. Question three is, how many people are you comfortable shooting a day? And if you answer below 10, you don't get the job. You have to say 10 plus. I am comfortable discharging my weapon into 10 plus people a day, no matter what. Are you scared all the time? Yes. I'm terrified of everything. How many anxiety disorders do you have? 4 that I've been diagnosed with. Are you terrified? I am scared of everything all the time. That's why I want to be a cop, because I'm scared. Good. We like fear. Are you scared enough to make something happen? Yeah. Be scared. Shoot first. Make things up later. They interview people for the LAPD. They're like, how proud are you to be a member of one of the most corrupt police forces in the history of... How proud are you? And yes, there's good cops and they get in shit situations and bad stuff happens. But the things that are happening now are beyond any justification. It looks like we got a bunch of like weird, scaredy cat, trigger happy freaks running around just emptying guns in a pit. And they're like, well, if I'm a cop, I could get shot. Yeah, but you're a cop. Like, that's part of the game. Part of the game is that you're encountering people that are not at their best. They're drunk. They're on drugs. They're dangerous. They're 12. You know, people when they're at their scariest, they're toddlers, literally. And you have to deal with it as a cop. You can't always be like, you know, but I get it. The cops go, hey, it's going to be me or them. It's going to be them. I'm like, yeah, but the guy didn't shoot at you and he didn't raise his gun at you. He threw the gun down and then he raised his hands. You know? Mm-hmm. Also, why not shoot him in the leg? No one shoots in the leg.
No.
They always go fatal force. And of course, I'll have 19 people on Instagram when I post the episode.
Yeah, yeah.
The reason, it'll be Kim Potter. The reason no one shoots in the leg is a bubble. Bad situations, man. Bad situations. And not an easy fix either. Listen to this. Can you bring up, just scroll down a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
This is when the cops made sense. New York police detective J.C. Williams, a recently divorced cop trying to be good father to his son, and Eddie Torres, a young Puerto Rican who struggles with his heritage, try to balance their stressful work duties with their own personal demands. Their boss, Lieutenant Virginia Cooper, is tough but fair in her assignments. That's when it worked. That is when it worked. Mm-hmm. When you had New York undercover, or you had Sipowicz on NYPD Blue, Dennis Franz, a fat guy who knew he was racist and that he should change. Every episode of that show was just him being like, I'm fucking racist. And a black lady was like, why are you so damn racist? And he's like, I'm trying, I'm sorry, I gotta do better. That was a good show. That was a good show because he worked for Jimmy Smits, who was a Hispanic gentleman. You saw how it all can work. Mm. If it can all work if you have a multi-ethnic police force and they're all actors. It can work if it's a television show. Policing in this country can be saved if it is on a soundstage and it is a television show. That is my hope. If you get people who are actors and give them fake guns and let them solve crimes that were written by people in a writer's room, we can save policing in this country. It's my hope. It's my hope. I don't believe we have any hope left for real policing. But I believe we can get a killer show. Let's solve this on TV. Let's solve this on television or on Netflix with a show about cops changing. Reform the police on Netflix. I want a show about cops struggling with their own internal biases on Netflix or Amazon Prime. And we can do it. If we work hard enough, we can do it. It's absolutely impossible in the real world. But I think if we had a show, a good show, where is there, your neighbor gets shot in front of you and you go, fuck. And you're angry. But then, and you watch the show, and in the show, there's a cop who was going to shoot your neighbor and decided not to. And then you go, they're not all bad. They're not all bad because I'm watching a show where cops are being good on the show. That's the goal. And when is it? It's interesting, like the decline of cop shows, and now all these bad cops are here. Because they have no role models. You know? Like they have things like Blue Bloods or whatever, but I'm talking about real good cop shows. Hill Street Blues, NYPD Blue, Homicide, Life on the Street, Law and Order. These were shows where even though the cops were racist and corrupt, they were likable. And you realized that you too were racist and corrupt. And that's what helped everybody through it. That's what made it okay when you saw these cops struggle with their own biases, that you were like, this is going to be okay. Keep going down. Look at all these. I mean, these are, what a great, can you bring up the opening sequence of New York Undercover, please, on YouTube? Opening sequence of New York Undercover. It was on Fox 5.
It was season one.
That is correct. Put the music on. This is when you know it's real. These are the cops. Think of these cops. stop watching the news. Watch this. That's Patty Quinn. She didn't shoot Baby Diablo. She's tough but fair. Dick Wolf is the only person who cared. Now go to NYPD Blue opening sequence, please. Because this, again, was a great show about good cops that were racist and corrupt. But you liked them. Here it is. Don't shoot at children. Look, multi-ethnic. We're talking. We're solving. Bad people are out there, and we're trying to help the good people. Yeah. But there's a black chief. Things are gonna be okay. She was the DA. That was 9/11. You believed in the cops. Now here's the, they go to Chinatown. You see the dragon. Watch. Where's the dragon? Show them, Jerry. Back. Should I pitch that? I got an idea. We got to do a cop show now, but good cops. It's hard out there for a pimp. And it ain't easy for a cop. It ain't easy for a cop. But every person I know who's been a cop has been a criminal before, first. Very interesting. I don't know what the process is to get selected. Maybe Lena Waithe will make something years from now where it's just cops skinning people, where cops are just boiling people in pots and eating them for dinner. Perhaps. I don't know.